Hi, in Excel, how to make the most of this perfect pair. We've got a few housekeeping items. As far as your questions, they can be typed into the GoToWebinar control panel. Today's webinar will go for approximately 30 minutes, and we'll have about a 15-minute Q&A at the end of the session as well. Without further ado, it's a great pleasure that I introduce our presenter today. It's BMGI's very own data analytics product manager, Shannon Murphy.
Great. Thank you so much, Tom. Thank you all for joining us today for this webinar. I'm very excited to show you how you can use your data in Excel and the visualizations in Power BI to make some very informative and storytelling dashboards. And that's what we'll do today. As Tom said, we'll go for 30 minutes, and I'm happy to answer your questions at the end. So today I am starting in Power BI. This is the desktop application, and you will see a blank screen. This is because this is where we will be creating our dashboard. If I click on the data tab, the data tab will also be blank because I have not brought in my data yet. You can also view from a relationship standpoint, and this would show you if you had multiple data sets, how they were combined by the primary key. So let's go back up to our report. This is where we're going to create our dashboard. And the first thing we need to do is we need to get our data. So I click on Get Data, and you can see there's multiple ways that you can bring data into Power BI. It can connect to many different applications. But I'm going to use Excel today. I'm going to connect to Excel. And I'm going to bring in the webinar data that I have created for this. Now, I will tell you, I have created this data. It is completely fictitious, and any company names or data that resembles something else is purely coincidence. I did not plan for that. So webinar data is pulled up from, it's connecting to my Excel, and it's going to ask me, what sheet do I want to focus on? Well, I want to focus on table one. And so this is a preview of the data. Again, completely fictitious data. I am pretending to be the fruit company. I sell fruit, and you can see when I sold it, what the description of the fruit was that I sold. We scroll over and we can see other information in my data set as well. The revenue, the customer, what state they were in, et cetera. So I click load, and it's going to load into my Power BI. And once it does, you see it's still blank. It is because we have not created any visualizations. But if I go back to my data tab, that's where my data is, just like it was in Excel. So it's kind of hidden behind the scenes and now allows us to create visualizations based on the data set that it's connected to. So I'm going to pretend that I'm creating a dashboard for the CEO, and the CEO is really focused on revenue and likes to see revenue visualized in different ways. So over here we have visualizations. These are multiple ways that we can look at our data within Power BI. And these are the specific fields of our data set that we have connected to Power BI. So here we see revenue. We see that it's going to be a sum of the revenue. And I want to look at revenue by month. That's the very first thing I want to do. So I click revenue and I click month. Power BI defaults to this chart. And if we go over back over to the visualizations, we can see that it is highlighted the clustered column chart. So that's what it defaulted when I asked it to show revenue by month. Within the chart, you can see that it's now showing revenue by year. So everything from 2000 prior to 2500. Well, that doesn't really help me. So this little circle allows me to drill down to the next level. So I'll click that, and now it's showing me by quarter. That's a little bit more information, a little bit helpful. I can see that quarter one was slightly larger in revenue than quarter two. But again, I need to see by month. So when I click on it one more time, this is it. This is the information that I have. And I can also click and drag this around the dashboard. I can also make it bigger and put it wherever I would like on my dashboard. So now I have revenue by month from January through June. Another thing that Power BI lets you do is not only do you get to visualize the information from Excel, but if I were to hover over January, it would give me the actual revenue dollar amount from that Excel spreadsheet. from February, March, April, etc. So not only is it a visual information, but you can also see numerically where your what your data is. Okay, so I have revenue by month. I want to put some other visualizations on here, and then I'll worry about making each visual pretty and custom and that sort of thing. So the next thing, besides revenue by month, I want to look at our states. So if you look over on our fields, you see that we have state information. So last time I clicked month and revenue and it told me what kind of chart it wanted. Now I want to tell Power BI, I want a filled map. So a filled map comes up again on our dashboard, and I'm going to make it a little bit bigger. And this filled map now needs to say, okay, Shannon, what information do you want in here? Well, I told you I wanted states, right? We're looking for a map. And so automatically it pops up the United States for me. And we can make this bigger. We can zoom in. We can move it around. And we can make it so that we can look at and identify the states within the United States. Now, as you'll see, some are colored and some are not. And what this means is that the ones that are colored in here are showing that there actually is data for that state in my data set. So you can see here, Virginia is mentioned in the data set. When I hover over North Carolina, I don't get that information. Nothing pops up. So North Carolina is not in my data set. South Carolina is. Let's zoom out a little bit. And what we want by state, we want to see the revenue by state. So it turned into almost a heat map for us. State, and some other states are light green. Again, when we highlighted and hovered over January, we saw the actual data. Same thing with states. If we highlight and hover over one of those states, it's going to show us the actual data for that state. It's colored similar to a heat map, so we know that Nebraska has the highest, given that it is the darkest state colored. I'm going to move this down a little bit. I'm going to make it a little bit smaller for us and easy for us to put some other visualizations on our dashboard. So now we have revenue by month, and we have revenue by state. I'd like to show you another visualization using our Excel data, and it's called the donut chart. So I click the donut chart, and it comes up, and it's waiting for me to put in information. So I'm going to start with revenue, of course. That's what we're looking at right now. And I want to do revenue by description. So remember, I told you that I was a fruit seller. So you can see that I have strawberries, pineapples, oranges, bananas, and apples. And again, this is representative of all of January through June information. So our revenue by description, this all equals 100 because it's showing us how it is allocated per the description. So if I hover over strawberries, not only can I see the dollar amount of that revenue for strawberries, but I can also see the percentage. So I can see that for this time frame of January through June, strawberries represented almost 72% of our revenue. So somebody might look at this and a creative marketing person might say, well, strawberries seems to sell. Maybe we could sell bananas if we said, hey, if you sell strawberry and bananas, we'll throw in a packet of yogurt and a recipe for a fruit smoothie. And maybe that would create some lift within our revenue generation. So this is one visual way to look at what it is that you're selling a lot of, and maybe you could boost some sales in some other areas. Okay, so now we have revenue by month, by state, we have it by description. There's other things that we can look at too. We can always go over and look at our fields and see what other variables do we have and how else can we see revenue. Well, we have sales reps. So let's look at revenue by sales rep. Revenue by sales rep. Now this is going to do another clustered column chart for us. And although this is helpful to see that Steve and Debbie have sold the most, followed by Earl and Russ, we want actual numbers. So we don't want another bar chart because two of the similar charts on the same dashboard might not be visually appealing. Another thing is maybe we just want to see the actual numbers very quickly represented right next to that sales rep. So if we click within this clustered column chart and we go over, we can pick another way to visually represent this information. So we can say that we want it in a table, and automatically we have those exact numbers next to the sales reps, and that gives us very quickly the revenue associated with that sales rep. Another way that we can show this information is called a tree map. And if we click the tree map and make it a little bit bigger, then visually and with different colors, you can compare the size of blocks represented within those sales reps. So again, you can see Steve and Debbie have a lot of revenue, and Betty down in the corner doesn't have much. And visually, this is a great way to see this revenue information by sales rep. So we'll click back on the table, and now we have sales rep and revenue information very clearly that we can see. So let's say, you know, we're halfway through the month, we have January through June information, and we want to see where are we compared to the goals that we have. Well, a way to do that is to pick this gauge here. And the gauge shows up blank, just like everything does, and we want to look at revenue. So it's giving us a dollar amount of what our revenue is, $7.67 million, and that exactly ties to what the revenue per sales rep, by sales rep, was. Power BI default halfway to 15.3. But what if these weren't our goals? What if we wanted some other thing here? Well, we can go over to this paintbrush, and when we click on the paintbrush, as long as we're highlighted within that chart, we can change the criteria, we can change colors and whatnot. I could add when it was so everybody knows the time that it was current. And maybe I want to put on here an email in case they had any questions. So shannon@fruitcompany.com. And so now we have our text box, which it did this. And you can see that sitting right here. We'll go ahead and center this and make this nice and pretty. And we'll make the font a little bit additional things that you can do. Go a little bit smaller so they don't overlap. And now my dashboard is coming to life. I have some information on here. It's starting to look like an actual report that I could give to. So there's many things that you can do to cut the, what I will make sure that I, a visual and a dashboard is very personal. So not only is it, but to the CEO, one of the things that you could do is color coordinate it and make sure that the colors are similar to what your logo is for branding purposes or dashboard to do, is to tell a story and to convey information. And you want to do it in a clean way, you want to do it in a concise way, but it also needs to be visually appealing, because if it's not visually appealing, they're not going to take the time to look at that information. So I'm going to use the next 10 minutes or so to make this a little bit more visually appealing and show you how we can customize some of these components of the visualizations. So I will tell you, 15 minutes into the webinar, and we have already visualized 5 different ways our information that's in Excel. So we've looked at revenue 5 different ways. It didn't take us that long at all. So let's go ahead and start customizing. One of the things that I would like to do is I'd like to change the gauge, and I can go over here to my paintbrush, and I can look at the data labeled. I like to have them black. It shows up a little bit more. And let's make so we can change the font there. You see how it happens in real time. The data colors, perhaps I want, and I want to make it the red of the apples in my logo, and I'm lucky that my art department gave then we can look at a background. This currently does not have a background. It's off. If we click that, it goes on. And we can change this custom color as well and make it the blue that is in our logo. And I can copy that from here, from my art department. I can put it in right here. And now I have the same blue as I do in my logo. So now it's starting to look a little bit more branded. Let's go to this table, and this looks kind of small. Those numbers are small. So let's go to our paintbrush in our table. And we want to put a title. So the title is currently off. And we want to call it Revenue by Sales Rep. We want that to be black because that's the color that stands out for us. And I want to make it a little bit bigger so that we can read it. And then we can make this a little bit bigger, and let's do, hide that, our background, we want to put that on, we want to do a custom color and make it blue to match. And now we have a little bit more branding there as well. I can go through and do this. I can make the bars red again in here to do a little bit more branding. Let's go do that. Our data colors. I want it to be a custom color. I want it to be the red from my logo. And isn't that pretty? We'll change our title to make it black. And hopefully by me showing this to you in multiple visualizations, you get the idea that it's easy to do and the repetition is helping you know where to go to make that happen. Now we're changing the background, and we want the background to be this blue. And you can see that it's starting to look more like a branded dashboard that we would send to our CEO. This title's good, Revenue by Description. That's exactly what we're looking at here, so I don't think I need to change that title at all. And I will change my background. And when I do that, these colors need to be changed, and I can do that as well. You go up to Data Colors, and it's going to show you each data point by the name and what color you want to make it. So maybe strawberries, we make a pinky red, apples, maybe we make a green-ish color, bananas. We can make a pink, and then our description is different for each one. One of the other things that I want to show you that you can do with this dashboard is you can interact with it. So if you click on a specific subject within one of the visualizations, you'll be able to see how it changes the rest. So right now, I'm clicked in revenue by month. I told you before, if you hover over one of the months, it's going to show you the actual data. But if we click on it, it actually changes the other visualizations on your dashboard to reflect just what you have selected. So here I selected January, and it's showing me on the gauge exactly what the revenue is for January. It's 1.6 million. It's showing me what the sales reps did for January, what the states were for January, and again what the products were for January. This is very helpful information if you want to slice and dice your data set. So I showed you by the month. You can also do it by just clicking on apples, and it'll show you the apple revenue for each month up above. You can hover over it and see the actual information. So remember, we clicked on apples. That's how we were slicing and dicing it. Now we're hovering over January, and it is showing that that's the total revenue. The 1602518 is our total January revenue. But what we've highlighted, what we've selected for apples, is that 318387 number. So again, very neat way that you can very quickly slice and dice your information. And all we do is click back in here to see the rest of everything. Okay, the other part is when we are in states, we can do the same thing. We can highlight on a state and see what Georgia did. Now, I told you before Nebraska was the biggest, so it looks like Nebraska is 2 million of our revenue sales for this month, for this year so far, and it's showing us what that number is. And again, slicing and dicing this information, the analysis with the Excel data right in Power BI. I didn't change this title here. Go over to Paintbrush, title, make it black. Make it a little bit bigger. There we go. And like I said, a dashboard, a visualization is very personal. We can put borders around it if you want to do that. There's different things that you can do. Play around in Power BI. See what you like. See what the board of directors likes, the people looking at the dashboard. The most important thing about a visualization is it's telling the story. It's representing the information. That it's visually appealing and you're getting across everything that needs to be communicated to the executives. So with that, that concludes what I wanted to present to you. Tom, are there questions that have come through, or Mark, are there questions that have come through that I could answer? And to everybody on the line, thank you so far. If you have any questions, I would encourage you to type them into the console, and we can start with the questions now.
Yeah, hi, this is Tom. Let's see, we have a couple here. Let's see what we have time for. If I email the dashboard to a colleague, will they be able to click on the visuals to interact like you've just shown?
Yes, absolutely. So what you have created here is, and this gets back to, great question, the very beginning when I showed you these tabs over here. So we're looking at it from the report standpoint. If I click down here, I look at it from the data. So when I save this, I do file save as you would any other, and you save it and you title it, and it's a .pbix file. You save it and you email that file to your colleague, they will be able to slice and dice it just the way that we did here. So they will get this file just the way that you're looking at. It'll show as a dashboard. They can click and see the data, and they can slice and dice it and say, I just want to look at strawberries, or I just want to look at bananas. So great question, Tom.
See, another one is, do I need to recreate the dashboard every month when I get new data?
No, you don't, and that's one of the fantastic things. So again, you know, this took me 25 minutes to create this dashboard. I'm showing five visualizations of revenue, slicing and dicing, and in those 25 minutes, I've now created it, and we can add information very quickly. In fact, I can even show you how we do that. So again, we brought in the data set, and I can go to that Excel spreadsheet. This is actually my data set within Excel, and this is on sheet one. On sheet two, I actually have the next month. So I have July's information. I can just copy and paste it over here. However you would update your data set, your spreadsheet, that would happen automatically, right? So however you need to put in the next month, you would go ahead and do that, or if it happened, I'm going to save it as that same name, and then I go back into my dashboard, and I want everybody on the call to watch these three top visualizations. I'm going to click this button up here called Refresh, and watch those top three visualizations. So now we see over here, we have January all the way through July. It automatically updated. So remember, we used to have 7.67 million. We're now at 8.62. Now we still have on here our target. This is still showing as a gauge. Our sales by rep number increased, and trust me, so did these down here. So if you were sending this out for the next month and wanted to include July, there are two things on this dashboard you need to update. We called it Revenue June 2016, call it Revenue July, and update this date over here of the date that you published this dashboard, and you're off. And so to answer that question, no, you don't have to recreate, and we just added July's information, updated our dashboard, and we can send it out in less than 60 seconds. It is a great partnership of Excel and Power BI. I love this tool.
Okay, let's see. Can I save this format and use this dashboard for other data sets?
Sure. So organizations are set up differently for their analytical department or their business intelligence department. So I'm guessing that question is coming from, well, it could be different ways. Maybe you do have a different data set, but maybe you're a different department, or maybe these descriptions of strawberries and apples are actually in different divisions within an organization. So absolutely, if there's a CEO or CMO that over all of it, but wants to see multiple data sets in the same fashion, there's another great thing that you can do within Power BI. So let me show you what I mean. You go to File, you want to export as a Power BI template. And then in here, you just type whatever kind of description that you want for your template. You say OK. You want to save it for wherever it is that you want to save it onto your desktop. And then when you pull up that template, it looks like this. So you'll see this looks exactly the same as the dashboard that we created, but it's not giving us any information. But remember, that's what we want. We want a template, which is the same thing that we can give to the CMO, the CEO, whoever is responsible for all these different divisions. They want to see multiple data sets, multiple pieces of information the same way. This allows them to do that. So I'll draw your attention to the map. It's showing the map of the entire world. So this would be great if you wanted to look at sales in Asia, sales of the exact same thing. So perhaps you have your sister company in Europe or in Asia, and you want to look at a dashboard for them the same way that you look at them for the United States. So now you have a template. You can share the template. Everybody can use the template. And you do not have to recreate it for a different division or a different data set. Great question. Anything else?
Yeah, we got a couple here. Let's see, how would I print the dashboard, or what would that look like?
Okay, so heaven help us, somebody's old school and wants a hard copy of this dashboard. Never fear, you can do that as well. So the way that you print, if you go over to File, you'll notice that print is not an option. Just a couple of things that you need to do. You actually need to publish this report to powerbi.com. So you click on that. Yes, we want to save changes. I'm going to call this Dashboard 3. And it says, I'm working on it, Shannon. I'm publishing this for you. And we want to open it up. And now I'm on the internet, and it is showing me what Dashboard 3 looks like. So it brought up a web browser, and this is my dashboard. I'm not going to be able to edit it or anything, but I can go over to File, and you can see that I can print it from here. So it takes just a couple of steps, but absolutely, if you wanted to be old school, maybe you're having a conference and a meeting and no laptops allowed, but you want to have the piece of paper in front of you to dissect these numbers, it's a great way to do that as well. So yes, you can print. Any other questions, Tom?
How can I learn more about Power BI in general?
Yes, in 30 minutes, this was kind of quick and dirty about a fake company and fake information, real fruit, but we're just pretending with this information. So there's lots more to learn within Power BI. It's a very powerful tool, and I currently work for BMGI. We have a two-week class. The course is called DataMaster. And on our website, you can actually learn more about the DataMaster class. Like I said, it's 2 weeks. So that first week, we show you Power BI. We dive into Excel. There are two different components, that kind of the advanced Excel, the solver, and the analytic tool pack. We dive deep into Excel and how to use them for optimization, parameter setting, and we learn about Power BI. We learn more about how to get information, so how to obtain it, how to scrub data. What I showed you was relatively clean data, but sometimes we need to transform some variables, and we can do that in Power BI. And so if you go to bmgi.com/datamaster, you can learn more about our DataMaster class and Power BI. We use in tandem with Excel frequently in that class. So this is the web page that you would go. You could even click on the tools section, and I walk through a little bit about the tools that we learn within the DataMaster class. So that first week, you're learning the tools, you're learning statistics, we talk about linear regression, how to build a hypothesis, the analysis that it takes, how to ask the right questions, we get into Power BI, and then that second week, so you have 1 week, you go back to your employer, you use those tools and those new skill set, then you come back for your second week, and we walk through RAP Analyst, which is an artificial intelligence desktop tool, and then we also explore R, which is a programming language that a lot of statisticians and data analysts use to manipulate data in kind of some easier ways, again, visual and looking at the statistics there as well. So we actually have a class coming up August 29th, which will be in Denver, and the second week for that class is in October. But again, at this website, you can see where they're offered around the world. Like I said, the first one is in August for Denver, but we also have them in South Africa and in Europe, and then you can also look at some of our 2017 offerings as well. That's how I would encourage you to learn more about Power BI. It's a fantastic tool. We use it here at BMGI, and our clients do as well. Are there any other questions?
Let's see, we do have a few more. I think some of them you've answered throughout, you know, some of the other questions, or when you were pulling up the print section, there was a question if it could be shared to an intranet, and there was a save option there. When you showed the save to print, there was also an option to publish to web. There's a lot more flexibility with the application for that side. Can we bring graphs from two or more data sets on one page? My understanding is yes.
Yes, I didn't go into that, but you can bring in multiple data sets. You can still get data. And then again, that would go to this relationships tab, which show you, so right here you see table one and then the column headers down below. Should you bring in multiple data sets, there would be other tables over here, other tables over here, and then it would show you the relationship between those tables. So yes, I apologize, in 30 minutes we just looked at one data set. We did a very simple dashboard, but Power BI does allow you to incorporate multiple data sets, figure out the relationship between them, and look at many complex visualizations that way. Great question.
Absolutely. There's a few more questions. Most of them are centered around the publication to intranet as far as security. I think they're more general, be it infrastructure or application specific. So I think there might be some better targeted follow-ups for things like that as well. But
okay.
I don't see any other general questions at this time.
All right. That sounds great. I will touch on the security just really quickly before I close us. You can publish on the web. Power BI has the option to publish to a public gallery where you can say, hey, this is, if you feel really proud about your dashboard and the data is not sensitive, you can put it out there for everybody to see. But you do not have to. And when you publish, it is still safe to you, your login, your password. But you also can publish it to everybody who could access that website and get to that information. So then you could also go out to their gallery. When you go to their gallery, you can look and see lots of different visualizations. Perhaps it would spark some creativity or see how somebody else sliced and diced information. We use that here within BMGI. It's a great sharing community. So yes, you can publish and it can be public, but you don't have to. That when you publish to print, it does not go public. So with that, I just wanted to touch on that really quick. I will show you just again a little bit about the DataMaster class. For those questions that you feel you still have, or if you think of any at the end, feel free to email datamaster@bmgi.com, and the DataMaster data analytics team will be happy to help you. I also would encourage you to go on the website and learn a little bit more about the DataMaster class. On the website, there is also an opportunity for you to subscribe to something we call All Things Data. It's a monthly email blast that shares data refreshers, is what we call them, so little tips and tricks that you might have forgotten about, which is really great. We also share what's trending in data, which, as you can imagine, there's lots of stuff going on with the Olympics and politics and that sort of thing. So what's trending, and then we also might have quotes or really cool visualizations that we came across. It's just an opportunity to share all things data within BMGI world. We will also tell you about all of the events that we have going on globally with related to DataMaster and other data analytics. And then we also offer discounts and special coupons just to our All Things Data subscribers. So I would encourage you to do that if that's something that you're interested in. I thank you very much for your attendance today. This webinar is being recorded, and so you can go back. Once we publish it on our website, you can go back if there's something that you missed or you need another refresher. I would also encourage you to share it with colleagues that could not come and attend the webinar live, or social media if you thought it was beneficial. So thank you so much.